And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Tampa Bay Rays going up against the New York Mets. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Just about ready to go, and towing the slab in this one, Justin Verlander. What's the word on him?
Well, that 12-6 curveball explodes out of the hand, and because he's able to throw the high fastball at the top of the strike zone for a strike, hitters commit to that pitch, and before they know it, they're swinging over the top of that curveball.
And here's the first baseman, Yandy Diaz. The wind of the pitch. That one finds the zone, and we're underway from Queens.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
The next offering misses, and it's 1-1. There's a strike. Chris, Justin Verlander has had a lot of notoriety since he was first drafted. Second overall pick by the Tigers in 2004 out of Old Dominion, and a guy who has won 3 Cy Youngs and as well an MVP. Plus, he's been a World Series champ 2 different times. Next one just misses. The count now 2-2. Next offering is fouled back. Comes a 2-2. That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. Kicks and fires. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. The pitch stays alive.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Here comes a pitch. Gets a piece and stays alive. Two, two now. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. The pitch. Caught him looking for the K.
Well, getting a good look at the pitcher here in the first inning isn't a bad thing. I know he struck out, but you can live with that as long as the other hitters in this lineup can learn something from it.
Now batting Wander Franco. And first offering is fouled off. Verlander, a multi-Cy Young Award winner. He features a four-seam fastball, a slider, a curve, and he works in a changeup. One down, base is empty. And that's in for a strike.
Dangerous spot for that slider right there. Didn't seem to quite finish out front and get that sharp break. Tell you what, he doesn't want to throw that pitch again.
The 0-2.
That's a ball.
And a ball evens the count.
He's trying to stay down in the zone, but the hitter just will not chase. Now back in a 2-2 count, he's going to have to go to something else to get him out.
That misses the zone, and that's ball 3. Righty delivers, and that's ball 4.
Take your break.
Man, that's a tough one to take on the full count, but I guess he saw it really well. It's a really nice plate appearance.
One down. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Runner takes off. Swing and a miss. Throw to second and he's out.
Such a quick and fast swing of emotions right there. You get the runner on with the walk, which is great, but then picks a bad pitch to go on and you just erase the free pass that you were issued. I understand you want to be aggressive. You want to try to get into scoring position, but you just have to be a little smarter there.
The 0-1. That one missed. Two outs. Good eye right there.
It's a good take.
First inning, and already up to 23 pitches. Next offering is fouled back. And now the count filled up 3-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And a pitch. Got him looking, that's a strikeout. No score as we head to the bottom of the first. Back here at the ballpark and starting on the mound for the Rays, Jalen Beeks. How about a report on him, Chris?
Well, he throws the change in the slider off the fastball. I really like how he's able to sell fastball, but it's really change up and keep hitters just out in front a little bit. Swing and miss, soft contact. The slider as well comes out of the same tunnel. All three very deceptive, and hitters are going to have to stay back and make sure they get pitch recognition.
Starling Marte stands in now, looks at that one inside. Kicks and deals. There's a strike. Ground ball, left side, and it goes just foul. The wind of the pitch. Out to short. Franco tosses to first. One up, one down. Let's take a peek at the Mets lineup here. And with their ace on the mound today, they're just looking to provide him a little bit of run support, and they'll see what they can do for him.
Boog, you have to be really careful when you've got a guy like this on the mound for you to not become a spectator. You know that he doesn't give up a whole lot, but sometimes guys get a little too comfortable and don't have an urgency to score runs. You have to make sure you put him in a situation where he can get the W, but also you guys can cruise to the finish line and not have to worry about a comeback in the end.
Brandon Nimmo, batting with one down, takes a strike. And it's even
ball
up.
In.
And a pitch. And downstairs.
One strike.
Lifted in the air, right field. Margot settles under it. He's got it, and there's two away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Jeff McNeil in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Line drive makes the play, and it's out number three. Nothing for the Mets in the first. Second inning coming up from Citi Field. Nothing here on the show. All set for the start of the inning. Lau at the plate.
The second baseman, Brandon Lau.
Verlander back to work. And that's in for a strike.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end. Trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front. So off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Next offering misses, and the count is 1-1. Assigned to home plate duty is Ricky Holiday.
Boog, and something I've heard players saying about Ricky's strike zone is how he will call the high strike. That could be something that's tough to deal with, especially if you've got a guy out there coming at you with high velocity.
One ball, two strikes.
So far, all we've seen in this at-bat are fastballs. Look for him to slow it down right here ahead in the count.
The pitch. Started to go after it. Now we'll look down to third, and he held back, according to Dave Lawrence. Here's the 2-2. Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. And there's one down. Harold Ramirez at the dish. And it's fouled away. No score here in the second. Fouled off. He was late. The wind of the pitch. Can't connect on the curveball. Struck him out.
Well, he's really dialed in, and this offense is going to have to do something to try to break that rhythm. Maybe it's square around the bond, step out of the box, agitate him a little bit, do something that just changes what's happening right now, because at this pace it's going to be a long game, so you got to figure it out quickly.
And there's a ball. Swing and a miss.
One ball.
And the count 1-2. Got him swinging.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Back here in Queens, we head to the bottom of the second, and now here is Pete Alonso. A couple of quick nuggets on Pete Alonso. He graduated from the same high school as Wade Boggs, Plant High School in the Tampa area, and Alonso also played at the University of Florida. He was teammates there with Harrison Bader. Next pitch is popped up. Lau has a beat on it, and a quick out number one.
Batting fifth, the shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
And now it's Frankie Lindor, a switch hitter batting right. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Good eye right there. The wind to kick the pitch. Swing and a ball lifted left field. A Rosarena moving under it. And he makes the catch. Two down.
fell off to a great start. He's really cruising out there on the mound. He's got a chance to get through these first two innings with under 20 pitches. That could set him up to go deep into this game.
Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit. Just missed. Next pitch off the play. Two balls, no strikes, the count. Swing and a miss, strike one.
Well, he came right at him right there, challenged him with the 2-0 fastball. Not sure exactly what he was looking for, but got to imagine that's a confidence booster on the mound. You're in that hitter's head a little bit.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Tommy Pham at the plate and takes high there.
Maybe losing command a little bit after the walk. Next pitch, not even close.
And there's the strike.
1-1.
And another ball. Escobar leads off first with two down to the inning. Off the mark there. 3-1. Mark Canna up next for the Mets. The 3-1. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, interesting. He went with the off speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
So two down. Here's Mark Canna. First offering misses the mark. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. That one misses. Two balls, no strikes.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming.
That one is absolutely belted. Dives, but it falls. And now it looks like extra bases. One run's in. Now the second run is in. It's 2-0.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
So, runner at second, two down. Tomas Nito at the plate. Ball. And ball one. Runner at second, two down. Hey. Next offering is in for a strike. Good eye in that spot.
Inside, ball two.
Strike two.
And he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Next pitch is downstairs. Starling Marte waiting for a turn at the plate. Line drive, base hit right field. Canna headed for the plate. The throw in, but it's offline. It's 3-0.
Comes through with the RBI. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
So the lineup flips over. Here's Starling Marte, grounded out his first time. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
That's just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm right front there. Side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
So first and second with two outs. Brandon Nimmo will hit next. Little chopper rolls foul. The 0-1.
Hey. Well, we call that keyholing. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
That one inside, now 1-2. Nimmo checks his swing. Appeal down to third. Got him. Dave Lawrence rings him up. Three runs for him here, and they move ahead. We head on now to the top of the third. It's the Mets 3, the Rays nothing. On to the third inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Isaac Paredes. Paredes goes 5 feet, 11 inches, 215 pounds, and he's a native of Mexico. That's in for a strike.
Players from Mexico City to Baja California have been in the league going back to the 30s. Mexico has been represented every decade for nearly 100 years now and has a strong history in MLB.
And here it comes. And he hits a ground ball right side. McNeil gets it to first. Leadoff hitter gone in the third.
Batting it. The catcher, number 14. Christian Bethencourt
next to hit for the Rays. Ball one there. The 1-1. And that's in the dirt. Way high. Down. 3-1 is on the way. Swinging a foul straight back. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Boog, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Oh, that's a good question. I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. Jose Siri, the next to hit, takes ball one. Siri, in his second season, hitting ninth in today's lineup, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. That one's in there. And a count 1-1. And strike two.
Knowing that the pitcher wants a ground ball double play opportunity here, you've got to lay off pitches down in the zone. Right there, swinging at that pitch, that's a no-no.
And that's down and away. Bethencourt leads off first with one away. Next one misses, and it's a full count.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
And the right-hander deals. Downstairs, and it misses ball four.
He's making things difficult for himself right now out there on the mound, but, you know, his confidence should still be high enough to get out of this, but he's going to have to buckle down right here.
Yandy Diaz now. That one's in there, 0-1.
There it was, a high-velocity fastball in the zone. I think a little frustration from walking the previous hitter. He's got good stuff. Pitch inside the zone and trust it.
Here's the 0-1. There's a strike.
Oh, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Next offering way off the plate. One out. Runners at first and second. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Bethancourt around third. Here's the throw to the plate. One run is in. Throw comes in and holds the runner at third. They're at the corners now with still only one away.
Picks himself up at RBI. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Here's Wander Franco. He reached out a walk his first time. In there, and it's 0-1.
The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot.
Runners are at the corners, one away. That one pushed foul, out of play off to the left. Little trouble with this one behind the plate. No advance. Good job behind the dish. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one misses. Now 2-2.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there. Like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
On the ground, two ball. McNeil. Lindor, that's one, but no throw to first as he'll hold on to it.
Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena.
Now the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. And there's a strike on the outside corner. Arozarena, 28 years old, and he's a former Rookie of the Year. Next offering is down low. And the righty deals. And a count 1-2. Now a fly ball to right center. Marte moves under it. He makes the grab, and that'll do it. So it's two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left. We head down to the home half of inning number 3. Gets the Mets 3, the Rays 2. And welcome back as we go to the last of the third. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Beeks back to work. Swing and a bouncer. Diaz. The flip to the pitcher covering. Leadoff man retired here in the third.
First baseman, Pete Alonso.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. 0-1 so far. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. That's a little bit low.
And that's a pitch early in this game. He needs called for a strike. Struggling with command issues. He's got to get a little help from the umpire.
Swings through that one. The 1-2. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, that was the cutter down and in right there. And typically, if you're going to have a chance with the pitch, if it's down, that's your best chance of doing anything with it. It's kind of like a mini slider, just with a little less vertical movement. But still, that one tied him up, and he couldn't get the barrel to it.
Lindor takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. That one ran inside, almost got him.
Not showing great command so far in this at bat. 2-0 count. He's got to execute here, or this could get ugly.
That one missed. Now 3-0. Strike.
It's a good changeup to hit up in the zone. I don't think he recognized it. I'm sure he'd love to have that one back.
And he walked him.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much
now
to think about.
Third baseman.
Next to hit, Eduardo Escobar. He walked and came around to score his first time up. In the air, left side. A Rosarena brings it in for the third out. So it's no runs, no base hits, no errors, and one left. Three innings complete. It's the Mets 3, the Rays 2. Welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. Now it's the second baseman, Brandon Lau. The pitch. There's a strike.
Oh, he's looking great so far. It helps when over 80% of your first pitches are strikes. He might be able to go the distance if he keeps this up.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Righty to the plate. That one just misses.
His understanding of the strike zone, very impressive. That was a very close 0-2 fastball. I just don't know how you take that.
Swings and misses, struck him out.
Well, pitchers have become so much better at commanding that high fastball. It used to be that a lot of guys didn't like to throw it because it threw off their release point and their mechanics. And they're aimed at keeping everything at the knees, get ground balls. But because hitters get a swing path that can lift balls at the knees up in the air and over the fence, this pitch has come back into play, and they are doing some special things with it.
Oh, he brought it back.
Got the pitch that he wanted, just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open, backside collapsed a little bit, and the launch angle not where he needed it to be.
Manuel Margot up to the plate. His first at bat was a strikeout. Pitch misses inside, and it's 1-0. And that one is lifted in the air. Bounces over the wall in foul ground. It's an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Isaac Paredes now. And first offering is fouled off. Margot stands at second with two gone. The next pitch misses, and that's ball one. And now 1-2. Looking. A double in the inning, but they leave him stranded. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Mets 3, the Rays 2. ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for New York, Tommy Pham. The wind of the pitch. And that's outside.
Well, these Mets doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at bats out of them. They worked three walks already, so that proves they're not anxious up there. They're sticking to their game plan, and it's working.
And he deals. Softly hit to third. Paredes slings it across. And one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Now back, the designated hitter, Mark.
So up next for New York, Canna. Mark Canna. One for one with a double and a run scored. And that's in there for strike one. And the pitch. Ball now one and one. Ball. Pitch misses. And that's ball two.
Looks like he's being a little cautious with him in this at bat after doubling the first time up. Doesn't want to make another mistake.
And now the lefty hit on the ground to the right side. And he handles it himself for the out.
Now batting catcher, come up. Nido.
Here's the catcher for the Mets, Tomas Nido. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. In there for strike one. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. That one in the dirt. Ball one.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
And a 1-2 again. Fights it off. You'll see another.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these guys are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet.
Next offering is downstairs.
He missed the zone, but I don't think he missed his spot. That was a good pitch with two strikes.
Swing and a line drive and a base hit up the middle. So now back to the top of the order.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
And the Rays manager making his way towards the mound now as he will make the move. Jalen Beeks won't go any further tonight, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. Now a new pitcher for the Rays, Garrett Clevinger.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
Starling Marte up to hit. And he swings and misses at the initial offering. at the belt and fires. Hit in the air, right field. Margot settles under it. And that is the third out of the inning. Mets leave one, but they're up 3-2. Back here at Citi Field, top five, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Christian Bethencourt. The right-hander back to work. 0-1. That one lifted to left. Coming on is Pham to make the play. And there's one away.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay closed.
And now it's Jose Siri. A walk and a run scored his first time. And that's downstairs and outside. And the 1-0. That clips a corner. There's the strike of the knees. One and two here. Just missed.
Really nice slider right there, sweeping across the dish, but just couldn't hang the edge.
Here comes a pitch. And that one lifted in the air center field. Nimmo has it sized up. Snags it for the second out.
The first base is number two, Yandy.
And now the first baseman, Yandy Diaz. And first offering is fouled off. Two down, nobody on.
One ball, one strike.
And a good eye there. That's in there. 2-2 now.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
2-2 now. Just off the inside edge. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
And just keep handing out gifts, Booth. Or are we supposed to bring something?
See, I think just our presence is the present. Two outs, runner at first. Wander Franco, the next to hit. Swing and a pop-off in foul ground. Pham moving under it. Here comes the 0-1. Yeah. And that's in for a strike.
0-2.
Way one inside, ball. Gets two out strike. Of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Next pitch inside, and it's 2-2. Diaz off of first with two away. Popped up and makes the play, and that's out number three. The Rays strand just the one. They're down 3-2. Back here at the ballpark, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's Brandon Nimmo. The pitch. There's a strike. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Number 58 getting loose out there. Poche, a left-hander, also throwing. The pitch. It's the slider in there for a strike.
Two really good back-to-back sliders. Now in an 0-2 count, he's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
The next offering misses, and that's ball one.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand, probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch, so got to stay ready for it.
Tried to check his swing there, appeal to third, and he went around. Ruled a swing. Jeff McNeil stands
batter,
in.
Number one, second baseman, Jeff McNeil.
That clips the inside corner for a strike. Next one is off the play, and that is ball one. The pitch. That one ripped. Got it. Really had to move for that catch. Two away.
Now back. First base is Pete Alonso.
Here's Pete Alonso. That's through there for a strike.
All one's the count.
Strike two.
Quickly in an 0-2 count, you've got to figure out a way to shorten your path to the baseball. Put it in play somewhere, then you got a chance.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Nothing doing for the Mets. They still lead it 3-2. Top six, and stepping in for the Rays, Randy Arozarena. Verlander back to work. Top of the zone, and it's called a strike.
Ball set to throw pitch number 100. He needs a quick inning here if he's going to be able to make it through six complete.
Kicks and fires. And that one moves his feet. Down and in, moved his feet.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Got him looking. One away.
Boog, he was shopping at the buckle right there, the way that slider made him look. That was just nasty.
Second base, Brandon. Wow.
And now it's Brandon Lau, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Lau, a former All-Star, 28 years old, and he was a third-round pick back in 2015. And now 2-0.
struggled a little bit in this one. A couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
There's a strike. Swing and a base hit.
Well, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
Man at first with one gone, and now the DH, Harold Ramirez. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Verlander moved to first. And he's back in safely. Lau leads off first with one away. Next offering upstairs.
Two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
Here's a 1-2. Battling here as he fouls it away. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know what happens.
Here's Manuel Margot. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Kicks and deals. And that one in the air center field. Nimmo makes the catch, and the inning is over. So one hit is all they get. We go to the bottom half of inning number six, and the 5-6-7 slots due up. It's the Mets 3, the Rays 2. Back here in Queens, bottom of the sixth inning, and now the shortstop, Francisco Lindor.
Well, both sides equally as strong, so not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. Activity in the bullpen. Ryan Thompson warming up for manager Kevin Cash. And a pitch. Just missed. Next offering misses, and that's ball three. Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here. And there's ball four.
Definitely lost the handle during that sequence. Four pitches for the walk, and that last one didn't even threaten the zone. Catcher might want to go talk to him.
So a man aboard. Now the third baseman, Eduardo Escobar. Escobar in his 11th season, a member of the 1,000 hit club, and he was born in Venezuela. Lindor the move, and first offering is fouled off. Nobody out, runner at first. Cool called strike three on the fastball, and that ran back over the inner half.
Well, definitely a borderline pitch right there, and he didn't look too convinced as he headed back to the dugout. You know, those are tough ones to let go as a hitter, but with the human umpire calling balls and strikes, it's always going to be on you to protect yourself with two strikes.
Here's Tommy Pham. Step off throw to first. Lindor back in there.
Some of the greatest players in the history of the game were born in Venezuela, including one that finished with 500-plus home runs, 3,000-plus hits, and a triple crown.
First offering, and it just misses. Step off, throw to first. Lindor back in on a dive. One run game, one out, one on. That one's in there, and the count even 1-1.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch, and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger.
Runner on the go. On the ground to third. Tosses to first. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
The designated hitter, Mark Canna.
Mark Canna getting ready to hit. And a good fastball to start him off at strike one.
One's the count.
Line drive, base hit. Lindor zipping around third. He scores, and they lead by two.
Well done. Drives in the run. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Runner at first with two away. Tomas Nido digs in now. And that one fouled off. Canna, the runner at first with two gone. Bounce to the right side. Whips it to first. That ends the frame. But the RBI single pushes across a run. It's now 4-2. Major League Baseball is on the show. Taking over on the mound for the Mets, John Curtis.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves. Late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Isaac Paredes.
The third baseman, Isaac Paredes.
The pitch to the right side. Toss to Alonso. That's the first out, the top of the seventh.
Now batting, the catcher, Christian Bethancourt.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Christian Bethancourt. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor.
I was always told it's hard to take you off the field when you play really good defense, especially at a premier position, and that's what he does.
And it is 2-1.
The hitting's going to come around. He's going to figure it out. But right now, his big asset is the way he plays the game on defense.
Fouls one off. 2-2. Now all even up. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. And And the right-hander deals. There's a swing and a drive. Pham going back, back some more. And he makes the catch on the track. Just missed a homer that time. Jose Siri, next to hit for the Rays. I think when you contemplate him as a player, the first thing you think about is defense, and you think about that great arm.
I also think about the speed. If he can get on, that's going to give one more thing for that pitcher to think about.
That's in for a strike at 95. That's strike one. Action in the Mets bullpen. Brooks Raley preparing to come on if needed. Robertson, the right-hander, also getting loose. And a pitch. Ball one low. Now a check swing at the 1-1. Look down to first. He did not go around. The pitch. Just off the outside edge. Yandy Diaz up next for the Rays. The 3-1. Swing and a miss. Line drive brings it in for the third out. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. They trail it here. 4-2. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Colin Poche.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
Back to the top of the lineup, Starling Marte up now for the Mets.
Starling Marte.
And he deals. And that one is inside ball one.
Well, these Mets, simply put, are producing a lot of quality swings. They've hit 7 line drives already, and even though some of them have been for outs, there's nothing wrong with delivering consistent hard contact. That's almost always going to lead to positive results. He was all over that one. When you can turn a ball around at 107 off the bat, it's going to make you feel really good inside. If he elevates that a little bit more, it's definitely out of here.
Digging in, Brandon Nimmo. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. Right through there for a strike.
I got a ball, one strike.
Kickoff move to first. Marte dives back in. Another move to first. And he's back again. Runner at first with no outs here. On the ground, could be two. Over to Lau. Over to first. Safe.
Oh, he's in there.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
So digging in, Jeff McNeil.
Hey, now, let's go.
First offering misses the mark. Nimmo at first, one gone. Next offering is in for a strike. Yeah, that's a little high. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
In the air, left field, and there's two away.
Up next to the net, the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
Pete Alonso up now for the Mets. Alonso started after it, tried to hold up. Now a look to first. No swing. He held up. Darryl Parker with the call there. Next pitch misses. Now 2-0. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
That just misses, and it's 3-0. Francisco Lindor in the on-deck circle. And Poche ready to work. Swings through that one above the zone.
3-0 hack right there. See, man, I'm going to go for it.
Ripped to short. Low throw, and he can't dig it out.
You know, two-out errors are kind of like two-out walks, and sometimes even worse. You know, you think you're out of the inning, but all of a sudden, you get another out to get, and the offense has a great opportunity. They're looking to take advantage of and make you pay for it.
First and second, two down. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. That one's in there, 0-1. And that skips in the dirt. Next pitch is outside, and it's 2-1.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
That one in for a strike, 2-2. This one popped up, foul ground, first base side. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And the inning is over. Two left for the Mets as they can't add to their 4-2 lead. Adam Ottavino comes on now.
Well, he's the guy they hope to turn to out of the pen to lock down wins. So this game has gone to plan, more or less. Let's see if he can wrap it up here.
And here is Yandy Diaz.
The first baseman, number 2, Yandy Diaz.
The pitch. And there's a foul ball.
Well, these Rays just aren't putting great swings on the baseball in this one. Just one extra base hit for them, so they haven't exactly been hitting the ball gap to gap or out of the park. That makes it really difficult to generate runs.
Foul ball there. Right-handed reliever. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Upstairs. Righty delivers. That one missing inside. Oh. Swing and a line drive. Base hit out into center field. And the leadoff man aboard.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Wander Franco. Corner infielders guarding the lines, trying to prevent extra bases. In there, and it's 0-1.
Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important to getting back into this ballgame.
The 0-1. And the slider just misses.
Tried to backdoor him with that slider right there, but just missed off the plate. Good pitch, though.
Here's a 1-1.
Two balls, one strike.
And a foul ball. The tying run at the plate. Goes down looking.
Now, big strikeout right there, and maybe a little controversial with the call. I think he got a little bit of favor on the mound. No question about it. It's not exactly what you want to see in a big spot like that, and I'm sure there's some chirping going on from the dugout, making it clear that wasn't his best call behind the plate today.
Here's the left fielder, Randy Arozarena. First pitch just misses. Just missed.
Last two pitches have been down in the zone. Pitcher clearly trying to get that ground ball double play. But in this count, he's going to have to give in, elevate his pitches, and get back into this at bat.
The 2-0 is in for a strike.
That's a great take right there. Even though it's a strike, with the situation, runner on first base, you want to keep the ball off the ground. And you swing at that pitch, most likely you roll into a double play.
Next offering way off the plate. Brandon Lau to bat next. And a pitch. And that's ball four.
Ball four.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum very quickly. They're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Now a move being made at second base. And here's the pinch runner, Luke Raley. First and second, one out. Brandon Lau will hit next.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
On the ground, right side. And it gets by him. Throw into third.
He kind of rolled over on this pitch a little bit, but he got enough behind it to shoot it through for a knock. And you'll take that anytime you can get him to find a hole. Really important at bat coming up now.
Now, Harold Ramirez. And that's in there for strike one.
In the infield at the corners, don't be surprised to see them come home first and prevent that run from scoring.
Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Runner from third comes across. Tie ball game, 4-4. The tag at third, and he's out.
That's heads-up play right there. The outfielder knowing he has no shot at the runner at home, so comes up trying to cut that runner off at third and does a really nice job. Got to appreciate that.
The Mets with a new arm on the mound, Drew Smith.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Now pitching for the New York Mets, number 30, Drew Smith.
So up next, Manuel Margot. In there for strike one. Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Next pitch is in the dirt. And it's a ball and a strike. Bullpen activity starting up now. Tommy Hunter getting ready to go. Ball to strike. The pitch. Foul ball. One, two to Margot. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit. Just not able to square it up.
Got him. Good job at damage control right there. They get two runs on three hits. No errors and one left. Home half of inning number eight straight ahead. And we are tied 4-4. Now on the mound for the Rays, Ryan Thompson.
Number 81, Ryan Thompson.
Now into the ball game on defense, Francisco Mejia. He takes over as the new first baseman. Stepping in, Eduardo Escobar.
Went down looking on three pitches last time. Let's see if he can be a little more aggressive right here.
The pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
Pretty good pitch to take a pass at in a 1-0 count. Just not able to square it up.
Righty to the plate. That one missed. That catches the corner.
Get a little frustrated with the strike zone.
Next pitch is downstairs. Tommy Pham waits on deck. Tapped out in front of the plate. In plenty of time to first, Escobar out on the play.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
And that is in for a strike. Strike one. Tied at four. And that one off the outside edge. Action in the pen down there. Josh Fleming warming up for manager Kevin Cash. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. ripped to short, snagged on a bounce. Gathers and throws, and that quickly two away.
The designated hitter, Mark Canna.
And next is the designated hitter, Mark Canna.
Showed a really nice opposite field approach in his last at bat. Though he came up clutch earlier in this ball game and really just needs to take the same approach. Think hard right back up the middle.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
0-1.
Right-hander kicks, deals. And that's ripped into left, base hit. And that extends the inning.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. That pretty much split the zone down the middle, and those are the ones where you've got to make them pay.
So a change being made at first base. Pinch running here, Tim LoCastro.
Number 25.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Tomas Nido. Thompson checks on first, and LoCastro dives back in. That misses. Ball one.
Count 1-0.
Two outs. Popped up. Lau makes the grab, and that's the inning. Mets strand one. This game's all tied at four. So coming into the game now on defense, Luis Guillorme. And man, they're asking a lot of him to play completely out of position. Pitch hitter coming on, Josh Lowe. Big spot for him here. And the pitch. Popped up. McNeil drifts towards it. Brings it in. One away. And now the catcher for the Rays, Christian Bethencourt. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out. And a foul ball. And the 0-1. And there's a ball.
1-1.
Stirring in the bullpen for the Mets, Tommy Hunter, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Next offering is foul back.
Really going after him here. All fastballs to get ahead in the count.
That misses the zone, and it's 2-2. Four in the ninth. Swings and misses, struck him out. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. Jose Siri, the next to hit.
Now this guy, a player that, if he gets on base, has the ability to really be aggressive getting around the base paths.
First offering misses badly for ball one.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number nine hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
Bounced, and that got the pitcher. And it's a 1-2-3 inning. Three up, three down that time. To the bottom of the ninth we go. Top of the order, due up. And we are tied 4-4. So remaining in the game defensively, Josh Lowe. He'll play third after coming into the game as a pinch hitter. Back to the top of the Mets order. Starlin Marte up now for the Mets.
Really nice swing in his last at bat. Shot a line drive into center field.
And here comes. Swung on, belted. That one's back. Gone. Ball game. That was a moonshot. And the Mets walk it off 5-4.
Hitting a walk-off homer is the kind of thing you dream about growing up. You're in the backyard, you're creating the most pressure-packed scenario, and what do? You come through with the big swing. Well, he was living a childhood moment right there. Nice swing of the bat, nice win for the team.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious New York Mets. 5 runs, 8 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base.